These are Carolina parakeets, passenger pigeons. These are ivory-billed woodpeckers. We have over 200,000 specimens. It's one of the largest collections at a university in the United States. And we're lucky because we have specimens from all over the world. They're not just from Michigan or even just North America. This is the Bird Division Research Collection. This part of the museum is not open to the general public. This is an Impian pheasant. These live in the Himalayas. Our museum specimens are not like the ones that are on display that the public would see when they come to visit the museum. These are used for research by professors and graduate students. The DNA advances have just been incredible. There have been thousands of changes in the last 5-10 years in our ideas of the relationships of different animals and plants. We've had this specimen here since the 1950s. The Himalayan forest thrush. For a long time, it was considered to be one wide-ranging species. They did get a tissue sample from our specimen, and they got DNA out of that. They found that there were significant differences in the forms, and so that really clinched it for them that there were actually different species here. The oldest specimens that we have are from the 1830s. Because museums have specimens that were collected over a long period of time, they're really useful for looking at changes in natural populations through time. We have had certain people suggest that it would be good to just photograph the specimens and then we could just get rid of the specimens and it would save a lot of room and storage costs and all that sort of thing. However, as this particular specimen indicates, a photograph is not the same as having the original specimen. You can't get genetic samples from them. And you never know what technology people are going to be using in the future. I think studying all of the different kinds of animals and plants helps us understand our world better and how interconnected life is.